Today's Hindu editorial that I'm going to discuss is weighting the cost. A prohibitively expensive vaccine, besides being unacceptably, will not be a little good. With the over 6 million cases and the death toll from COVID-19 approaching 1 lakh, India is entering the first winter of the pandemic. Viral infection, particularly of the influenza variety, of the also common at this time of the year, and there may be a new unknowns in the risk that lie ahead. However, the another potential milestone approaches the probable availability of vaccine. Union Health Minister Harshvardhan, on multiple occasions, he has said that an India-made vaccine was likely to be available in early 2021. The government already has an expert committee on vaccine distribution. Their job is to decide who gets the vaccine first, how many will be eligible for the early does, what the cost would be, and whether whether there should be a cost at all for the majority of Indians, who anyway were the hardest hit by the pandemic in the summer. And shortage supply of vaccines also problems as dotting as making one and pose a complex challenges in India. The government is yet to make its policy on distribution but the current thinking appears to be that nobody would be denied a vaccine on the grounds of affordability. There is even discussion that a vaccine may be available via the National Immunization Program. This initiative currently offers at least 9 vaccines for preventable diseases free for children and pregnant women. The pandemic global nature has meant that even the quest for a vaccine is in tentational, and the GAV COVAX Alliance has emerged as the largest coordinator of vaccine development as well as distribution of a probable vaccine based on combination of payments by 78 high income countries and donations. The Gavi COVAX aims to ensure that between 15-20% of every country's population, or at least their most vulnerable, are able to be inoculated first. In principle, these are laudable aims, and the underlying principles of equity, a paucity of testing facilities and equipment in March led to stringent restrictions on who could be tested. Though the tests were free, they were first available only in government facilities, and this contributed to a significant pool of understand carriers. Carriers and rapid spread of the virus that was only marginally blunted by the lockdown. Only after the number of labs explanted, the both public and private labs restrictions on who could get tested were removed, and a greater variety of tests became available. That disease management was, even though that vaccine delivery will be protracted. Protracted process, and it would be a little long time before the average citizens had access to do it. There are at least 3 Indian companies testing their own vaccines, and so prohibitive expensive vaccine, besides being unacceptably, it is also unlikely. So this is our today's editorial. Thank you.